three-game loss streak, they actually really think that the team was on such a good page coming into the games today. We'll see if they can end the week on a high note.
Their aims aren't just to, you know, not go to relegation. Their aims are for playoffs. This is a team that, with their eyes towards World, they want to start getting those points in the spring split so that they won't have such a hard time in the summer split getting enough points to go to Worlds.
And I don't want to undersell the Team Liquid playoff scenario. They win here. They're 8-8. Their last three games, by the way, are Coast, Winter Fox, and Dignitas.
Yes.
Like, they should end the split 3-0, improve to 10-8 overall, which is a good chance of squeaking into sixth place. So Team Liquid have to keep their hopes high. They have to realize there's a probably better than even chance they actually make playoffs, despite their record right now. So keep it going. Kennen, Rek'Sai, Sejuani, and Band on one side. Nidalee, well, you can see him up there. But the first pick, Lissandra, comes in for Coast.
Team Liquid with the Nunu Lulu. I really feel like these buff the AD carry comps are the way to go when the meta turns towards tanks. So we'll see if Team Liquid can finally get a strong game with Piglets. They've got Dominate setting up to support him. They've got Quas or Phoenix possibly setting up to support him. Could even be special with the Lulu, but already giving away a lot. With those first two picks, you know exactly what Team Liquid are doing. It's going to be a full buff the AD carry comp. I mean, so Coast should pick accordingly. They already have one point and click with Lissandra. See what they followed up with here.
So here's the thing about Liquid.
Gangplank plus Brand.
Unlikely. Unlikely. They actually ran this comp the very first game of this year
with
Keith. And he went 6-1-11 on Kog'Maw. It was great. But they're already facing a bunch of hard CC. There's an Alistar. Lissandra's picked up here. Chris. He's very energetic. Looks like Welcome to Heaven and smiling as well. So Coast is really happy about this game.
Yeah, so he played Gragas in his first game yesterday, and not the best Gragas ultimates. So he's definitely going to have to make those Gragas ultimates count, because those can really disrupt a support style team. When you're an AD carry playing forward, if you try and play it like the Juggernaut term, where he's on the front lines playing more aggressively, and a Gragas ultimate knocks Lulu out of range of ulting you, you're counting on these defensive abilities coming from your supports. If Gragas can separate the team, that can disrupt everything for Team Liquid.
Yeah, but so far, Coast, a lower damage support. I feel like of the tank supports, Leona a bit higher for damage output here, but it seems to not matter. It will be Vayne for Piglet.
Interesting variation.
Janna comes in, so I think it actually makes a whole lot more sense. It gives him the outplay potential. He's shorter range, so he's always in Lissandra range.
Plus, it's his signature champion.
But yeah, it's
that's always nice to see.
Probably going
to
run his own skin, too.
Well, let's see what sort of bottom lane Mashmi will decide to go with to pair with Alistar. Now, when you're facing a team that's all about peeling the enemy AD carry, I feel like you, too, want a long-range AD carry on your side.
Yeah, so they can participate. Ezreal and Graves would be two good ones there. Saber can help the team go in.
Yeah, or you want to be, a support carry sort of like Sivir and allow the rest of your team to just dogpile the enemy. But yeah, they'll go for the long range. They'll go for the Kog'Maw.
Oh, well, it's a multiple knockups. Alistar and Gragas to set up for Yasuo. I mean, talk about reaching into the back line. That's going to be a real thing. Phoenix, he might get the exact matchup that ManCloud played yesterday. They're hovering the Cho'Gath. Maybe a bit of a shout out to Team Impulse.
Uh-huh. ManCloud got a little bit of flack for not pulling off the Cho'Gath versus Yasuo counter. He got killed by Rush, though. It was jungle Nidalee intervention. Not really fair terms there for him. Now he's kind of laughing because he's on the other side of the possible matchup here. Cho'Gath also does provide quite a bit of zoning, and the silence is huge when playing against Lissandra. It's just another line of defense for protecting Piglet. If Lissandra comes in, usually her moves are telegraphed, fairly short range to rely on just flash ultimate. But we won't see the option here anyway. It'll be a more standard Ahri here from Phoenix.
All right, so Liquid only running three supports, no mid Karma. Phoenix not going to be buffing Piglet almost in any way.
Run decoy for him.
He can run decoy. So two major carries for Team Liquid. Coast, back to the jungle. Gragas, Yasuo for ManCloud. Mash on a Kog'Maw as well. Bit of a new look for this team, but two very well set up hyper carries. A bunch of disruption to keep Kog'Maw happy, and a bunch of knockups to make Yasuo happy, and Chris just able to be Lissandra, who's always annoying at all times.
Yes, and I really feel like there is a lot on this Gragas. Very few knockups are long range like that, that can set up Yasuo's ult from so far away. So again, you know, if Piglet's off by himself, they can delete him very quickly. Also, Gragas does stay relevant later into the game. When Nunu gets 4,000, 5,000 plus HP, Gragas will be doing a large chunk of that every time he activates W.
That's totally fair. We'll see if that happens then in this matchup. But as the teams load into the game, start sending your votes with hashtag CSTWin or hashtag TLWin to at LOL Esports. Team Coast have nothing to do but show that they are a good team. Team Liquid looking to make a run for playoffs. Who's it going to be? Going to load ourselves in.
All right, boot start here for Man Cloud. Looking to dodge some skill shots with Yasuo. Charge up his shield quicker. And whenever you have a team with Alistar on it, you have to be careful about checking brush. So we'll see if Team Liquid, yeah, it looks like they're just spreading out rather than going for the invade for any sort of deep wards.
You know what's always weird to me about teams that run these battle lines? Mm. They're never quite an LCS order. The top lanes go to the top, jungler's next, mid laner goes mid, and the AD carry and support always do it wrong. Every team does it this way. I don't even know why.
Your next chance to interview someone.
Why do you run all the way to bot lane?
Got to get to the important questions for you. I believe... Let's see, what can we come up with here?
Close to the lane. They can't be too far away from the minions.
Yeah, the CS. Got to get back there quicker.
I could say if you do see a lane swap, you're there in time to freeze it, and the support can like help your jungler jungle. Like, there's probably some real like gameplay reasons why.
Not buying it. But the lane swap, we will see the lane swap here from Team Liquid. Try and get Piglet off on his own. Want to get him off to a good start. Same thing we just saw from Winter Fox. They were basing a lot of their hopes and dreams on Altec. So they sent him up top to try and get an early start. Did not work out that way.
Yeah.
Because of a heavy focus from Coast and some great plays from the support.
And interestingly...
Well, as Impact.
It seems like Coast have sniffed this out because they were about to start on the Krugs and realized, actually, you know what? Kog'Maw should build a freeze here. And looks like we'll have a freeze on both sides. Coast, they had a trinket ward in this brush. Notice, wait, Vayne's still not here. All right. I see something here special.
Gets chased out of enemy territory by Chris.
This is supposed to be his jungle. His duo lane is on this side. They're trying to stop Welcome to Heaven.
Yeah, interesting that they have Dominate starting their own red buff rather than coming for the invade with Special.
Special's getting rich, but Heaven...
50 gold,
damage.
I don't know about rich.
Oh, hold on. There's always a chance. Okay, Giddy waits. Even dodges the... all right, cool. Shared XP on the blue.
There's no way a Janet Tornado level 1 is going to do over 200 damage.
AP runes.
Okay.
Take a page from Ziggy's book.
I still don't think there's a way that...
No. I think it's actually impossible. It's all right. Either way.
Maybe flashed in if you had a... You can't even ignite...
Can't even ignite
them
anymore.
Can't ignite them anymore. That's too bad.
RIP Shaco Spotlight.
Anyway, Piglet was able to get the freeze off during the jungle harassment by Xspecial, and I do like how Xspecial is hiding in the brush, so Coast are not aware when he starts to roam. But everybody jungling on their own territory here because both started top side.
No disruption, though, at all from the bot lane of Coast. The double jungle of Kwas and Dominate able to grab the... Again, what you conventionally consider a greedy blue buff there since they're near the enemy duo lane, but...
I feel like a lot of that has to do with Xspecial gaining the information that Gragas started their own blue buffs.
And he's holding down too.
Unless Gragas wanted to make a beeline and waste some time, go blue to blue. Pretty easy calculation there for Team Liquid to start it off. And a very calm game here. No early support visits toward the mid lane. Kind of missing those.
It's true.
In the lane swap.
They're busy counter jungling.
All-Star not the biggest impact level one before he can make his combo, though, so. See what Gragas can do off in the wings here.
Knock up, could layer him, and gets the body slam in. Phoenix flashes, but Ignite's gonna be enough. Down to the ashes, welcome to heaven, gets first blood.
Welcome to Coast. Phoenix. Heaven's able to get the first blood for himself. See what he can do with it on the Gragas.
You know, that name doesn't really make any sense, since when Phoenixes die, they just get reborn. They can never get welcome to heaven. They just stay on Earth the whole time.
How many times? Yeah. Let's take a look here. Piglet.
Yeah. So they swap a duel in up to pressure Piglet in. And I mean, considering all the CC available and the fact that Gragas could roam up, you have to give Piglet someone to help him out.
You can see the quick call there from Team Liquid. Not only calling over Janna, but also Dominate deciding to jungle up on the top side just in case there's further pressure up there.
And they've got a Warden Tri-Brush to watch the most common gank path as well. All you could do now for Coast is really lane gank this. And hey, look, a Trinket to stop that as well. So Team Liquid, ungankable. Oh, hold on. Good damage here, but they fire back in. Chris gonna take a fair bit of damage. Team Liquid knowing their exact limits. Piglet really chasing this one. Oh my god, he gets him! Especially with the secure.
Piglet's not gonna lose any more games. He's decided to take things into his own hands here. My mid laner's decided to die, so I'm gonna have to take over. Because there's only two threats on this team. One of them gave up first blood. Piglet able to strike back though. You know, too bad that Especial decided to secure the kill.
It wouldn't have died. He secured him an assist.
He could have got his auto attack off earlier.
Okay, I'll give you that. Scumbag Especial.
No, but seriously, though.
Yeah.
Securing the kill there, literally, for Especial. Good job from him. ManCloud pauses to take aim. But Phoenix will be fine. Able to dodge that knockup.
All right, Coast sitting at about a quarter of the fan vote. First blood may have swayed that slightly, but Mash is sitting here actually undisturbed in his laning matchup. 51 minions on him. Can easily back for a phage when he wants it. He's well on his road towards Trinity Force. Looks like really not being stopped. Quas does have a slightly better laning phase than Chris. He's got 10 minions there. And the first scuttler bot side goes to Welcome to Heaven. Aggressive ward as well to spot out if the Gromp ever goes down. But a good defensive pink ward from Team Liquid's Especial, or anyone else who put that, will sweep that vision back away.
Welcome to Heaven really looking to turn that first blood and that mid flash down into something. But Dominate chases him off and secures a bit of vision here for Phoenix. They really do need to protect their second carry here.
Yeah.
They can't afford to be a one-threat team. We've already seen how two-threat teams do struggle.
Yeah. Like, just an AD carry killing tanks can work if the tanks can't reach you, like, theoretically. But with the disruption of Yasuo, Gragas, etc., I just don't think that's a realistic goal. Quas, though, a level up on Chris, starting to get some good harass down. Looks like this is a matchup Team Liquid expects to win in the top lane. They do not have great ward coverage for him, though. In fact, Welcome to Heaven should be able to, like, can walk straight up the river and would not be seen by Quas.
Quas is playing very aggressively.
They have a pink ward. Like, they know Gragas gets there safely.
But deciding to go for the Gromp, take his time moving up there. Chris is not level 6 either. That would be a huge, huge factor because Quas post level 6, hard to take down without that Lissandra knockdown.
See the trade power right there. Ulti comes in for Piglet. They really want Mash. Orcon Quan. The combo is down. They aim for Kog'Maw. Flash in. Oh! Q in. Can't. Oof. Mash lives.
Yeah. Quan Quan playing Bouncer. Not going to let him into that club. If you get too close to the turret, instant knock up there.
Yeah. Chris really getting pushed around. He's level 6 now, but Gragas is now on the other side of the map. He recalled and went bot side. Coast really not considering the fact they could go for a fight there. Quas had trinketed the river and cleared the pink out in the last 20 seconds or so, but Heaven not even making the trip up there when they did have the pink. Team Liquid now off the pressure in bot lane, gonna get a dragon for their worries.
Yeah, Piglet really creating plays for Team Liquid so far this game. Chases Mash Me out of lane, and Dominate's able to come in, pick up the easy dragon.
He sequences his abilities in the wrong order, though. He hit the smite way before it consumes animation.
Yeah. Generally, if you cast your Q, you can wait the small animation of the consume bite.
Yeah.
And then use your smite. Good eye, Freak, for a non-jungler.
Yeah, thank you. Makes me feel better about my jungling skill. It's like harder to miss smite on that champion. I'm like, yeah, I got it as Nunu, guys!
But then, when you do miss it as Nunu, as we've seen,
yeah, I'm just
you get more. You get more hate.
It's like failing to dodge a rocket grab is like Ezreal or Savory. Just like, really? It was max range. Come on, buddy.
Well, let's take a look down bottom. Early pink ward here from Xspecial. Yeah. Placed down without the lane control to defend it. Did he just place it? I feel like he just placed it and it was instantly killed.
Yeah, pretty recently. I mean, the bot lane got pushed in and Nunu wasn't there. Coast weren't afraid of that. I think it's a flashless Kog'Maw. Nunu does show it's bad. Welcome to Heaven shows up mid. Phoenix does not get the knockup, but Gragas ulti not in range. Mancloud can't hit R in time.
Yeah, close one there. But a good ultimate from Phoenix also. Dominate coming to try and resupply vision. And this is one of the, actually, we've been spending so much time talking about Piglet and Team Liquid.
Yeah.
This is one of the best starts Mancloud has ever had since he's joined Team Coast. He's had very few games with successful laning phase and all that done with an Avarice Blade. He sat on an Avarice Blade for the first 10 minutes of the game. So this is definitely a good sign for Coast.
Yeah, leading into this game, he was the number 10 mid laner in the LCS in terms of CS at 10 for mid.
Yeah.
200 gold off an Avarice Blade, gets a Shiv. Maybe in a decent spot. Coast equal in gold with Team Liquid right now. Reaching now 11 and a half minutes into this game. Piglet does have an assist to his name, but so does Mancloud. So two big volatile carries with two of the strongest backs, actually, Vayne and Yasuo, to bring their teams to victory. Mash does not quite land the stun. Heaven is here.
Teleport is also here. Can Piglet get out?
Slowed by Cog. They don't really chase onto that side. Chris picking the wrong direction to go. Quas comes in. And now what's it going to be? The barrel does not slow Piglet. The lockup there onto Chris. They might take him down. They don't quite yet.
Dominate.
The flash in. Dominate will claim one. Anything more to be done here. Coast forced to run away.
Good turnaround. Phoenix, though, under attack from Mancloud. Good answer for the teleport there. Quas coming in to get some counter engage. Now that was also a bit of a lack of focus from Coast there.
Hold on.
Splitting.
Team Liquid are staying bottom with all four. They match the mid lane, whatever, but four down.
Heaven.
Con Quad and Mash got to be pretty afraid on this one. No slows land from Glitterlance. Couple silver bolt hits Heaven. Body slam backs him out, but this bottom lane now is getting pressured out of the turret. No CS being picked up, no Xperia's being picked up, and the turret itself will go down. Team Liquid choosing to stay and being rewarded. Or not.
Well, they're just trying to deny as many minions as they possibly can. Mashmi's still in experience range, but he's second-guessing himself as far as going for the last hits. So a little bit of extra gold denied there.
Still becomes a freeze if Coast want to use that.
Let's see if Quas can shove it in further. The other thing is, though, we're already 13 minutes into the game. If Coast decide to freeze that bottom with Mashmi, all these supports can group up right now in the mid lane and pressure Yasuo. Yasuo, very dangerous wave clear to pull off.
Very true. They have to manipulate Chris and Heaven into the right spots to keep their turrets afloat. And maybe not going to happen here. Okay, Piglet gets the red buff. 13 minutes in, pretty early donation for an AD carry that early on. And look at that. Wards on the left-hand side. Dominate does have Sight Stone. Seems to be a common trend for many of the tank junglers to run that second Sight Stone. Help your support get wards. Team Liquid just with actually both Sight Stones on this side. Xspecial getting hit up a bit by Chris. Is there enough support? Heaven is there. So is Con Quan. That will be the kill on to Janna. Dominate doesn't have any damage footprint. He's going to back out.
Pauses for the drink. And Xspecial going down. That was only Alessandra ultimate burned for the kill. Mandatory Cloud going to do some damage here. Probably won't be able to pick up the final blow unless Phoenix walks into Alistar range.
Oh, oh! Flash Q, forcing flashback from Phoenix as well. Khan Kwan goes in. Nothing really gained. He was like, my man cloud. He like left that minion alive. He's like, I'm going to dash this. Yeah. I'm going to dash this.
Yeah, exactly.
And like Phoenix knew too. He was like, oh, this is tricky. Do a dance.
Piglet doing everything he can, though, this game. Okay, plays for his team. He has been a very positive force for the team as well, as we've heard in recent scrims. And even yesterday after the hard loss. Still had a smile on his face, trying to cheer up the rest of the team. So the atmosphere inside the team, even though they are on a heavy losing trend, trying to keep their heads up. And they've got the lead in this game, heading towards the point where they can group up with Piglet, almost at his first item.
Yeah, Cutlass, a lot of attack speed early on. He can almost afford Ruin King. He's like half a wave away. 50 gold short. He could sell potions for it, maybe. But he's not easily going to have that in time for a dragon unless Mash doesn't decide to match recalls with him. Mash himself, close to 280 force, but a couple hundred gold away. Piglet sneaks into the second brush, though. Mash unaware of this. He thinks he's safe. In goes Piglet, lands the stun. He's got a Cutlass, slows him down. Bunch of auto attacks come in, forces the flash, but the chase comes in. The trade blows come in. Piglet, oh no, he's got to heal the chase. And now with a passive land in time, but meanwhile in the bot side, there is a team fight going on. A full chain at absolute zero. Doesn't do that much damage though, and Dominate will be the first casualty on this side of the fight. Piglet did survive the encounter overall. One for one though, and Dragon Control to Coast.
Ah, the other four members there.
Oh, Chris! Chris, watch out!
Dragon's gonna take him if they don't take aggro off. Somebody turned that dragon around. All right, Coast are able to get closer.
Uh-oh.
They left him in the pit.
No, Kwan! Oh, no! Glacial Path was down.
Chris left out to dry. His flash just coming up now. Oh, man. His team left him out to dry.
Still aggressive in this one.
Kwan's looking for those Easter eggs, and he found one in the back of the Dragon Pit.
I learned something new just now. If you flash away, Pix like walks around the wall to chase. He actually couldn't Glitter Lance Dominate. Huh. Or Heaven, yeah, sorry.
Regardless though, Piglet with another solo play. He did second guess himself slightly under the turret.
Mm.
Didn't rush straight in with the heal, but saw that he could still get it with the heal. Turned back around, finished off the kill. And now Chris is going to teleport up into the 1 versus 2. He gets stunned to the wall. Piglet going again.
Xspecial has aggro, pops the ult just to land a little bit more crowd control, flashes out, and will survive the encounter. Piglet 2-0-2. He is 80% of his team's kills and assists right now. And that is going to be top lane outer going down. Team Liquid 2-0 on turrets.
All right, this is the exact start that Winter Fox were hoping for with their AD carry-centric team comp. Some early kills onto their main carry for Piglet. So already setting the team up for success here. Let's see if they can translate it into the mid-game control that they're looking for. Get some extra wards down so they do not get caught out. There's plenty of CC from Team Coast, so Team Liquid still do have to be a bit wary of those CC chains. And it caught out. Yeah.
It's only a 2,000 gold gain. Most of that is on.
Ooh,
he misses it. Most of that's on Vayne. So, yeah, one good fight. And you can't cleanse knockups. So,
nope.
QSS won't help there. No Black Shield on the team either. So, always the chance for Coast. Team Liquid's going to sneak Piglet into the bot lane, but no one's contesting here. Kwas, upgraded Trinket. We'll get a couple wards down. But Piglet doesn't find him in a fight just yet. Oh, they found Mindcloud now.
Piglet again, out for blood. He got hit by the knockup while invisible. Mindcloud didn't know he hit him.
Jumps on in, the Lulu ulti comes across. Mindcloud, oh nice dodge by Piglet. In goes Mindcloud again, can he dodge through enough minions? The answer is no. Boss TP's top lane to hold the turret. Another kill for Piglet here.
All right, they should be able to shove down bottom too. With Quas holding top, no teleport from Chris. Full map control here for Team Liquid. Janna and Nunu buffing up Vayne at this point. Ridiculously strong. Everybody from Coast has to give him a wide berth. Now, we talk about the knockups. Not much that Piglet can do as far as Lissandra getting right in there, but he technically can outplay all the other knockups. Gragas, you can tumble away from. Alistar, you can queue up a buffer for Condemn if he comes in for the headbutt, but the flash pulverize would be. Takes some amazing skills to get to react from.
Yeah. You can actually pulverize flash. So you'd like really have to predict. But yeah. You can't just wait for the flash to show up. Ooh, blue buff does go over to Quas. Chris now in the mix, ults himself, but guess what? Team Liquid is here. And Liquid seems to beat Ice in this one. Chris goes down 0-5-2. Very rough game for the Lissandra player. And it keeps going towards Piglet. He got an assist on this one.
I think that's what I'm looking for next in this game is some sick outplays from Piglet for these knockups.
Ooh. Yeah, 20-minute Baron. It's dark. Sweepers, yeah, you don't need them.
Vayne with Nunu, Janna Shield, and Lulu help picks on her with the Blade of the Ruined King already completed, and Nunu as your jungler.
He's maxed Silver Bolts already.
You cannot leave Baron without Vision. Oh, can he get a Miracle Steal? No, he's going to die.
Zossid runs away. Piglet's like, guys, Baron. Okay, Baron it will be. Quick claim right there. Red team has slain Baron Nashor. Team Liquid takes him like 20 seconds. They take it out.
Yeah. The other thing is that Dominate, he's very well known among high solo queue players as well as all LCS players for going for early Barons and early Dragons on various junglers. Nunu, obviously, the most common, but teams, pretty much all teams, really expect that even more versus Team Liquid than versus other teams.
You know, it's funny. I remember a story that was told to me by one of the other LCS teams. They said, we had a set of scrims against Curse back when Liquid was known as that. And they would tell us before the game started, we're going for a 20-minute Baron. And they would get it. they would tell them they're trying to, and they'd still find a way to make it happen. So, well, certainly something well practiced.
If you do have a 303 Vayne with a full support Vayne comp and a Nunu as your jungler, you have a good chance at pulling that one off. And this Baron buff should mean some turrets getting knocked down for Team Liquid. Let's see if they decide to get that group going or split off. Because, honestly, no single person can handle Piglet at this point, but probably even, well, maybe a combo of Yasuo plus Alistar might be able to handle him. All right, well, they group up, want to make use of the support synergy, and power down some turrets with this Baron buff.
Yeah, all the easy stuff's off the map. Okay, Dragon's up in 8 seconds. They can turn back for this one, but they're up to tier 2 turrets now. Mid turret does not grant the shield anymore, so it's a bit easier to take them before, but Windwall buys them some time all the same.
Yeah. And this is sort of one of the small drawbacks of the shorter range AD carry for these hyper carry supporting compositions. It's a little bit more difficult to take the turrets, but any of these supports can build Banner of Command. And since they have such a lead in this game, I would expect one of these supports to build a Banner of Command just to make it that much easier.
Yeah.
When they grab Baron to be able to shove down turrets. Vayne, though, early lead in this bottom lane. There's nobody from Coast in sight, so that turret is gone.
Nice rotation, yeah. Team Liquid giving this one to three members, the two buffing supports that increase her damage, and the Vayne herself. There we go. Turret number 4 goes down. Quas chasing Chris around the map. Ulti comes in. Chris might want to take this fight, but just feels so afraid. Lulu ult comes in. Chris might have eaten the wrong way. Forced to flash out because of that. Now bot lane inhibitor under fire, but Windwall again will buy some time.
Ashmi also. Training Force completed for Kog'Maw. Still definitely lacking behind Piglet, but he's working on it. Definitely still relevant in the team fights. Mancloud with the double item spike, at least, for Yasuo.
Oh, that barely even hurt.
Oh, could be the pick that they're looking for.
Nah, just an ultimate burn.
Fear Rush is still available.
Yeah. Finish with the components for Deathfire Grasp. The rest of Pepperonis, but mid lane under fire. And
Dominate does boot it up for a while, but he's just so darn tanky. There's the engage. They get it on a Piglet. He flashes out. A disruption ulti, but Dominate buys some time as well. They will get Expecial. 1-0 in Ko's favor, but Chris right away drops down. Piglet still able to hit on the back lines. He dodges Mancloud. And looks like the pressure for the turret will resume out of mana for most of Coast. And the turret is picked up in the aftermath of that fight. 1-1. But turret number 5.
Should let Piglet lifesteal here so he can get... Nope. Not going to try and press it any further. Combo, though, we saw how dangerous it is. They got very valuable summoners out of Piglet there for Team Coast with that initiation. Let's take a look here. The Condemn was used early on Alistar, so he didn't hesitate to go right back in. Mancloud jumping in him as well. Even Welcome to Heaven throwing the ultimate on him. Even with one support down, Piglet's still up on the front lines, by the way.
Like, the Kwas saved the ulti until Chris came into melee range. Like, he didn't need the health just yet. He's like, oh, I can get a knockup on this this Lissandra. And Chris being so far down couldn't afford a Zhonya's yet in this game.
You do need coordination between the various support players when running these teams. But again, only one outer turret left standing. They got two off of that Baron buff. Well on their way. Double death caps, by the way, for Lulu and Ahri, the solo laners. So very real magic damage as well from Team Liquid. Purely build armor here for the Gragas and Alistar. Although Gragas only does have armor.
Yeah, that's the problem. No one really has magic resist. You have half a Zhonya's. You got a Merc Treads. And yeah, you got to be careful if you're Welcome to Heaven here to not get just exploded by Lulu and Ahri. And Team Liquid with a minute and a half on the Baron. They could play for this again if they wanted to, I suppose. And really use that to hammer home the advantage of sieging. Certainly seems difficult for these guys because of the engage power of Coast. So let's go get the Western Jungle. No big deal. The Rebo for Piglet right on time for Baron as well.
Ooh, QSS done on time as well. Mm-hmm. So they have QSS and Mikhail's and all of the peeling abilities.
They got a locket.
As well as a locket shield.
Now we just need Face of the Mountain for Expecial on Janna. It makes no sense, but you know.
Maybe Dominate will get it. It does make a little bit more sense than usual, I guess. Let's see here, though. Sending Piglet back down to the bottom. Just collect all the red buffs. 45 seconds left on that Baron. I feel like that's the clear call for Team Liquid, because even if Coast venture out into that jungle leading up to Baron, a fight out in the open there would be just what Team Liquid wants to take at this point in the game. Huge lead, plenty of room for Vayne to maneuver around.
Yeah, that'd be nice to see if Piglet can dance around. 4-0-3 on him. He's still only missed out on one kill from Team Liquid overall. He's big and powerful. Blade of the Ruin King still 300 gold short for Mash, so looks like that is likely not to be there in time for a big team fight. And you won't be able to break down Nunu very fast. But we'll see if that happens either way. Team Liquid happy to play as a little bit more slowly. Dragon back up in 45 seconds.
Yeah. This game is too important for them to try and rush into anything.
Yeah.
And, you know, speaking of the new guys on Coast, you know, important games for them as well. They only get a couple to show themselves in the LCS.
Yeah.
And a vast improvement here for Welcome to Heaven on the Gragas. Much better this time around. Made the early play on Phoenix. See if he can come up with a Miracle Baron still. That's always nice to add to your resume.
It's true. Can you outsmite a team that used to have St. Vicious on it? And looks like the attempt is for Baron right now. Down to 3,000 health. Conquan is around. Heaven's here as well.
Oh.
Goes in. Not going to get picked up. It will go to Dominate. And this poor Gragas will get his first death of the game. Piglet, unstoppable. Chasing down into Conquan. True damage. Not blocked by the ulti. Flashes out Chris. Oh, no. Here comes Phoenix. And gets him in the back half of the queue. More kills for Team Liquid. Just maybe Piglet's buffed up. Dominate flashes for an Ice Blast, lands it, Chris goes down, Piglet dominating. 6-0-3. And it's a 5-2.
This should be the Baron buff to run inside the base. Death timer is still very low though, only 20, 9 minutes here. We'll see how much destruction Team Liquid can get. Maybe they go for the end. 20 seconds still left on Chris. Conquan and Welcome to Heaven will be back up, though.
Ooh.
And they go for it.
Jeez, Piglet just going in for damage on whomever he pleases. Mid lane inhibitor is down. Two Barons picked up by 29 minutes for Team Liquid. Easy escape outside the base. Mancloud will not be getting any revenge kills. Piglet spotted out by the Trinket as well. Out goes Team Liquid on 6 turrets so far. Oh, that's slow. Sorry, Piglet.
Actually gonna throw out the recall taunt.
I'm surprised they kept going after not recalling. There's so much gold in the coffers right now for Team Liquid. Conquan, though, stunned up there.
Whip
the windfall does enough. No engage happens just yet, but Dominant knocked into the team. Where's Mancloud, though? What can he do? It's a 1-for-1 so far. Into the base they go. Double kill for Phoenix. Piglet in the back lines. Actually gets the kill and a mash. The heals might not be enough. They don't go for him, actually. No, it's 3 men alive. An ace for the team.
This
triple kill for Phoenix.
To go. The turret
MVP! Bait of Piglet takes him down. But Phoenix and Quas, the two AP champions left up, they will take an inhib turret. The inhib itself likely to fall right after. Now what else do they get? Or do they recall?
Special died under the turret because he was trying to channel his ultimate for everyone else to get out. But then no minions. Piglet went back in. And another one falls to the deadly bot turret.
Yeah,
that
well.
Will put an end to its terror, though. Phoenix able to finish it. All right, take another look here. They're kind of trying to bait in the fight because, again, the short range, hard for them to fully commit to this. The wind wall here was amazing, but it takes so long to kill Dominate. The wind wall goes down, and there's the reinitiation from Team Liquid. After wind wall is down, they immediately jump all in. And Phoenix took the aggro first from the tower. When he Zhonya'd, it went straight to Piglet, the other carry. Worst possible situation, but as soon as Piglet got out of range, yep. That laser does slow,
yep.
And the tether range a little bit longer than the acquisition range, so it always catches people off guard.
Yep.
Doesn't stop firing immediately.
All right, so Team Liquid, though, sitting on an 11,000 gold lead, top lane tier 2, pretty easy pickup for themselves as well. And they've cemented a pretty large gold lead thanks to everything picked up. Phoenix is actually going, we're not going to see it. Luden's Echo. He's got the components of it. But I don't think we've seen one all weekend for North America. We saw a couple in Europe. I think we'll be missing out this time around. So it looks like the wave clear from Coast will stop Liquid from doing much, but bot lane getting pushed in. Mancloud will be the one to defend that. The mid lane wave crashing in soon. Liquid actually haven't gone for Dragon 3. I was surprised. I thought it was a bug, but no, only 2 dragons still for these guys.
Yeah, 2 inhibitors down. They want to make use of, you know, double super minions coming in to finish off this game. Not give any extra time to Coast.
Wow, Conquan down to a third, though. Push once more for the inhibitor turret. The poke damage very real from Team Liquid.
Coast wave clear here, too. You know, Gragas jungle, Lissandra spam Q.
Yeah.
And Kog'Maw doing his best.
Conquan might have to go back to the base to heal pretty soon, though. Very low on health, under 1,000. And with 2 sources of true damage, the Ulti's not even that good at staying alive.
Yeah, that's true.
Pink ward down immediately cleared. Not much of a reason for that one. Again, the you talked about Yasuo's wave clear being risky. His wave clear is, but the wind ball makes everyone else's real easy.
Yeah.
Team Liquid not making progress, and Mancloud keeps absorbing this farm that comes in from the middle and bot inhibitor. He has the highest minion kills in the game, by the way. Mancloud's big, and he's almost at Infinity Edge.
Yeah.
In fact, he can afford it right now if he backs.
And he's almost maxed wind wall. 4 points to do it means it's a 20-second cooldown. Could have it every wave.
Here they go up the gut. Mancloud, no time to buy IE. Is there time to clear the wave? I really think he needs this item. Have a chance of killing the back line. I mean, they can...
He's running for it! He's going to the shopkeeper!
All right. Infinity Edge is here. Mancloud. Power spike,
got
baby!
It. Run back quick.
Buys a potion in case he needs it for the fight. Can't blame him. 3 upgraded sweepers on Coaster. They do reach the back line. They can see Piglet through the invisibility. And again, you have a guaranteed, reliable Gragas ulti into Yasuo ulti to start the fight out. If the rest of the team is CC right. enough. Here's the push one more time. Can they get any damage down?
The wall
keeps them safe. Coast really turtling well.
Indeed. And Mancloud's been able to handle all of the inside waves with these super minions. Just destroying them with Yasuo. So Coast, they pull off the defense for a bit longer, buying themselves some more screen time and some more options for comeback.
And Team Liquid were so sure that they could have taken this on the siege with double inhibitors down.
Playing the stacking of dragons.
Exactly. They never tried for dragon. And now they get it. It was easy this time. It was easy before. But this time around, they will likely secure it. But now with all the time for the inhibitors to respawn, how deep can Coast get their wards up? What can these guys secure vision-wise? Maybe their own red buff, if they're lucky?
Krugs?
Krugs. That's 100 gold.
Give those over to Mash. He's got a Trinity Force and Bork already done, looking like that Phantom Dancer coming in as well.
He's 200 gold from affording it. They give him two waves. He's got PD. He could just go Shiv to shortcut it. Does? Okay. So very similar builds for the two AD carries of Coast. And now let's see.
All right, I'm still looking in this game for a really good Gragas ultimate that destroys Team Liquid to separate Piglet from all of the supports. That's really hard to pull off, but that's what we're looking for.
All right, so Quas and Phoenix supplementing their damage output. Lichbane for one, Ludens for the other. We do get to see the item. Kind of happy to see it. I think it's a good item, but no magic pen for him. And while to keep the team safe, out they go. Of course, Team Liquid, not a lot of engage tools and not a lot of range, but they can use Baron to supplement that and get around that weakness. And in fact, looks like that is the case. Scuttler goes down just to be sure, especially with a couple of wards down. Here comes the Baron attempt. It dies fast, but Coast want to stop this.
All right. Let's see it.
Armanda Heaven, Ice Blast in. Will they get what they need? There's the ulti on in. Who are they going to find? Looks like not much. Chris goes into the back line, but does not stop. Piglet Exhaust is on, but who cares? Chris goes down. 1-0. They get Mancloud. 2-0. Conquan makes it a third. This could be the game-winning push. Welcome to Heaven. Exactly. Dances come out from him. And Quas TP's into the base. There's an inhibitor number one. Inhibitor number two going to be there as well. Should be the game. 36 minutes in. Nothing to stop Team Liquid.
To find a mash me?
They're looking to find the next one. That one is going away.
Piglet wants kill.
Wow. That's great. He's on my fantasy team too.
Oh!
Piglet gets the kill. Only he's got 9 though. There's bonus points for 10.
Well, he also died and interrupted the spree.
I know. Really sad stuff here. But 10 turrets down. Team Liquid with a lot of barons and the Nexus in 36 and a half minutes. Felt longer than it was, but a fairly controlled game. I mean, they were just, like, when you get a 20-minute Baron and you're up 10k gold, you're like, all right, Liquid probably won this game. And then Coast made him work for it, to be fair. They're clearly not giving up on this season.
Opting for the shorter range squad, but able to finish it off there versus Coast, a game that they really could not afford to drop.
Yeah. Well, Team Liquid's schedule, to be honest with them, doesn't get much harder. Again, their next two opponents are teams that are now guaranteed to be in the promotion tournament. Team Liquid have it guaranteed at least 7th. They are going to be in the summer split. But if they want to make playoffs, they face 8th place Winter Fox and Dignitas in Week 9. Liquid have to expect that their record ends at 10-8. And their primary peers of Gravity and Team 8, who sit on only 9 wins themselves right now, are very much within reach for Team Liquid. This is a team that said, hey, we can make it to Worlds. We think we're gonna have to do this. They found a game where they finally put Piglet on a carry, and he did carry. The support comp worked. They have a chance to make playoffs, make the long but possible run at winning the spring split, going to MSI. These are goals in Liquid's mind. It's just a long road ahead.
Very, very long road, but look at those smiles. Glad to see them finally on the faces of those guys.
Mm-hmm. Tough road. They had lost 3 in a row. They can end the split on 3 wins in a row. Quas there getting his Lulu. Supporting the Vayne worked pretty easily.
Yeah, and honestly, they beat up Chris quite a lot.
Yeah, they did
as well.
Chris went 1-9-4. Not a great performance from him. You talk about the new guys of Coast, though. We said, hey, you know, these guys might feel pretty good about their performances. Conquan, 0-3-5. 2, 3, and 4 of Welcome to Heaven. He actually had both kills from his team early on. He started the game 2-0-0. The early gank pressure, you know, not bad from the new jungler picked up here. Hadn't seen him in competitive very much before. Khan Kwan as well, one of his first performances. Looked all right, but you could tell the team was new. We didn't get to see any of those Gragas Yasuo ults. And there were Gragas ults that hit four dudes. And if you're spamming R on Yasuo, you catch half of that. You catch most of that team, and you slice them up for a bit, and then maybe the team fight looks okay. But it just never happened here. Coordination flaws certainly there for Coast. The chances of comeback were there. You know, they held onto their base for a while. Like, some things went okay, but just felt like they got outganked and generally outskilled. All the solo plays by Piglet really punished Coast.
Yeah, I think that was one of the big takeaways from this game. Yeah. Piglet definitely not lacking in confidence.
No. And Team Liquid really not lacking confidence in him either. You were talking about it. I was talking about it. Liquid came out of this week feeling good. They're like, yeah, Piglet's talking. Like, we're winning in scrims. They said they faced TSM, did really well in scrims there. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, all right, Team Liquid, like, we're good. We're finally making this team comp work. I know I had heard so many critics say, just bring back Keith. It's clearly not working with Piglet there. But behind the scenes, Team Liquid's like, no, it's totally fine with Piglet. We feel great with Piglet. The team is talking. There's no animosity anymore. We're all happy. The attitudes got turned around. All right, you can maybe coast into the end of the season here, but I want to see how they shape up if they do make it to playoffs, what those games look like when they have some other very tough competition ahead of them. We'll see what happens at the end of the season for Team Liquid. But for now, to cap off our Week 8 coverage, going to send it over to the guys on the analyst desk.
Thank you, Freak. And they hit the nail on the head there. I think that this was a big, I mean, it was a big win for Team Liquid, right? They just needed a win in order to keep their playoff.
They could not lose this game.
They could not lose this game in order to keep their
mentally.
Yeah, exactly. And I think it's an important note that there is confidence in that, like, within that team, that there's a lot of speculation around the fact that the team is not confident when they play with Piglet. And, you know, yes, they've come out with losses, but I think this illustrates very well that they have that confidence by putting him on the Vayne and throwing support entirely behind him.
Yeah, we always wonder what the identity of this Team Liquid team is, because when they find most of their success this year, it's been really channeling farm into Kwas and I Will Dominate. But when they had Piglet come back the second time, that wasn't their strategy, and they started losing again. So they're kind of refinding themselves here. And if they take care of business next week, they're still going to be okay as far as the playoffs are concerned. But, man, they're under a lot of pressure in all of their games.
Yeah, and it's just that whole thing. Like, we talked about it when he first came on, and we saw them make, like, protect the AD carry for Keith. They do it for Piglet, pretty much the same result, right? Like, you don't make a star become a team player if that's just not the way that he plays.
Yeah, absolutely. To your point about that playoff run, winning the next two games for Liquid guarantees that the worst-case scenario is they play a tiebreaker for a playoff spot. Yep. So entirely in control of their own destiny here. They're set up to play Winter Fox and Dignitas, so they're entirely winnable games.
Yeah, the eighth and the ninth place.
Only playing teams below them in their last three games.
All right, so we have to basically look for them to take this confidence and roll it through and play as well as they did. Now, whether or not they can do that and whether or not Winter Fox or Dignitas will have anything to say about that is a different story.
Yeah. It's going to be a really fascinating last week. I think we're in for
a lot of movement.
A few tiebreaker games, a couple, a few, or a lot.
A couple, a few, or a lot.
Yeah.
Like, almost likely that if there's almost no scenario where it's like there isn't a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly. Almost, no.
So as we draw another week to a close, let's see how the playoff race is shaping up. Reclaiming sole possession of first place is Team Solo Mid, which means CLG slide into second. Sharing third is Cloud9 and Team Impulse, who continue their climb up the standings. Just one game back, we've got Gravity and Teammate tied for fifth. Team Liquid are in seventh place, and with their win over Coast, are now safe from relegation. But that means Team Dignitas and Winter Fox will be playing in the Summer Promotion Tournament to fight for their spot in the LCS. And in 10th place, it's Team Coast. Now, there were a ton of great performances this week, but here are the five players who broke away from the pack. In the top lane, we've got Impact.
Yeah, and I thought that Impact, I thought I had him nailed as on TIP, he's going to be a supportive top laner. Lulu, Morgana, Maokai. Then he brings out things like Rumble and has just great performances on Hecarim as well. He's the top lane for this week.
And then we move into the jungle and we find Meteos.
Yeah, and Meteos kind of marched to the beat of his own drum this week. That Vi game he had where he did not build sweeper, where he went full damage and just carried the game. And then even though in a defeat, his Nuna was very strong. Six 5 of the first 6 jungle buffs went to Cloud9, and thanks to Meteos' counter-jungling on Nunu.
Absolutely, and demonstrating 2 different play styles, which is what's really impressive. This week's mid laner is going to go to Slushi.
Yeah, Slushi showed that he's not just an Orianna player. He can play things like Lulu and be a team player. And you got to give him credit for that swag kill.
And when he is on that Orianna, playing well. At AD carry, we've got Gravity's Cop.
And this guy is just so consistent and reliable, but sometimes in really important situations that make him have these amazing scorelines. Very pivotal, him being able to bring damage in these team comps, because Gravity ran tank team comps. And if you do not have a damage source in the backline, those don't work. So Cop had a very important role to play.
Consistency is key this week for them. And our OP support also ran off with the top prize. This week, our MVP is going to go to Little Bunny Fufu, hopping through the forest and hooking enemies for kills left and right. He was a huge playmaker for Gravity and instrumental in Gravity's upset over TSM to get a 2-0 finish on the week.
It was a huge game, and his hooks were very pivotal, hitting them back to back to back. He was talking about 3-second cooldown. You're like, you got to hit him. He's like, I was hitting him.
It was almost like one of those games of NBA Jam when you become on fire and every single shot goes in.
You rain them from half court. They're half court. Yeah. Just
boom!
Like,
suddenly his hook goes twice as far.
Right. They're twice as high. It's twice as wide, twice as far. Yeah. Everything, yeah. And then his Morgana as well. You know, that's nothing to take away from his Morgana play to following up on Thresh. So fantastic play by him, snagging that MVP, much deserved. Now, our final week of the regular season spring split action kicks off next Wednesday with the European and North American Challenger Series. Then set yourself a reminder, because you won't want to miss an all-new primetime league. And on Thursday, the European LCS hits your browsers, starting with the Copenhagen Wolves versus Rocat. Then it's a battle for second place between Fnatic and H2K. The action in North America will return Saturday with Gravity versus Cloud9, followed by Teammate taking on CLG, and we'll conclude the day with Team Impulse versus Team Dignitas. Now, that's going to do it for us here in LA. So for myself and the entire live broadcast crew, thank you for watching and good night.
While Team Dignitas are sharing eighth place, this is an important game, but Gravity aren't in the business of giving away games.
Taunter to the backside of the fight. Kiwi Kid, oh, the Glacial Prison hits Core JJ and extends all the way to Kiwi. Very nicely done. Gravity take down Dignitas. Now eyes on the Slushi, highs low on mana, the missiles. No, he had it charged in, and he hits it, eagle eye high.
Bump turn.
Yeah, baby! Woo! No shoes, yeah, free win!
Woo!
You gotta be kidding me, Jet. What an amazing game coming out here from Teammate.
Bunny, do you have the sheet?
No, do you?
No.
What?
Bunny was even like sitting next to me.
Pick up the sheet and come back here.
But David is not supposed to leave.
Wait, he actually left?
Yeah.
Hey, what should we play? Crowd.
Ask them. Hey, what do you guys? They're the lull counter.
Yeah. It's
hey,
like,
what do you think we should play here?
We can make a run for playoffs. Who's it going to be? Goes for the damage. Abba Pobota takes the exhaust, but is there any follow up? Looks like Spray and Pray is gone. The javelin is in the back. Team Impulse, certainly not pretty. They take a win here in this one. It's a one for one so far. Into the base they go. Double kill for Phoenix. Hits into the back lines. Actually gets the kill and a match. Team Liquid, a fairly controlled game. They're really not giving up on this season.